It has not been proven that all these anthrax incidents involve the mail. But U.S. Postmaster General John Potter today urged Americans to be cautious when opening letters or parcels. The FBI has posted guidelines for handling suspicious mail on its website. They include, don't open, shake, or bump the item. Look for indicators like no return address or foreign postage. Evaluate the situation and call 911. The FBI website is at fbi.gov, G-O-V, or read the guidelines at cbs.com, click on news. The anthrax case in New York could not come at a worse time for the city, still feeling the hurt of the World Trade Center attack. And CBS's Anthony Mason reports it wasn't the only anthrax scare for the city today.
For New York, it was another day on the front line of fear.
Sidewalk. Come on, let's go.
In the trenches of terrorist hysteria. In Rockefeller Center, an anthrax case at NBC.
You just feel so vulnerable now because you don't know what's going to happen, where it's going to happen.
In Times Square, another scare and more police barricades.
I'm an editor at the New York Times, but they won't let me through, and the only thing they told me was that there's an investigation.
The New York Times had received a suspicious letter.
That some powder was in an envelope. It was open.
Tests showed no apparent danger, but New Yorkers had another reason to worry.
Checking your mail just took on a new meaning.
New York's Mayor Rudy Giuliani cautioned,
people should not overreact to this.
But according to a new CBS News New York Times poll, nearly three-quarters of all New Yorkers fear another terrorist attack in their city.
We've all been expecting something, not necessarily at this building, but I think that we all feel something's going to happen. I just didn't think it would be here.
But panic never spread in the streets. In this hardened and still hustling city, they've learned to expect the unexpected.
Well, what I'm noticing is that everybody's out here on a beautiful Friday afternoon, and nobody's, like, letting it freak them out. And I think that says a lot.
But even the false alarms are having a cumulative effect on the city's psyche, and in some ways changing the distinctive character of one of the world's greatest cities. Dan?
Live here in New York City, Anthony Mason. In the Florida anthrax cases, tests given to almost 1,000 workers at the newspaper office in Boca Raton have come back negative. Some local postal workers are now being tested in case they unwittingly carried a contaminated package. One newspaper employee died last week from inhaled anthrax, and two others who tested positive for skin anthrax are doing well on antibiotics. There are a lot of fears about anthrax, what it is, how you can catch it, and the true extent of the risk. CBS's medical correspondent Elizabeth Callatin has facts on anthrax.
Anthrax spores can enter the human body three ways. As in Florida, the rarest and most deadly way is to inhale them. They can also be ingested if infected livestock is eaten. And finally, they can go through the skin in something called cutaneous anthrax, which is what happened to the NBC employee.
She is in good health, in good care.
Cutaneous anthrax is the most common and the mildest form of anthrax. There are about 2,000 cases worldwide and a handful of cases seen every year in the United States, most of those from people who work with animals. It is not easy to get. You cannot contract it by having spores land on you. They don't eat through healthy skin. But a small cut or abrasion would be enough to provide an entryway. From there, the first sign of infection would be a small pimple or ulcer, which would continue to grow into a black, coal-like lesion. Anthrax got its name because an infection looks like anthracite or coal. Treatment involves antibiotics, Cipro, or penicillin.
With proper treatment, essentially no one should die from cutaneous anthrax. Period.
As a precaution, a floor at NBC News was sealed off. CBS even closed its mailroom. But anthrax experts say small quantities of spores in the air or on surfaces cannot infect large numbers of people. The cases are isolated and localized.
It is not contagious. That's the first point. The building is shut down to prevent any further exposure. So that no one, if there's been a case there, then presumably there are anthrax spores in the building, and we don't want other people to get exposed.
Public health officials are walking a fine line here. On one hand, they must convince Americans that these unexplained incidents are no reason to panic. On the other hand, they themselves have so little experience with anthrax historically, they are also feeling their way through unsettling new terrain. Dan?
Elizabeth Callerton, thanks. For more context and facts on the threat of bioterror, we're joined now by retired U.S. Air Force Colonel Randy Larson. He directs the Institute for Homeland Security and teaches on that subject at the National War College. Colonel Larson is in our Washington Bureau. Colonel, given how rare a disease anthrax is in this country, is it fair or unfair to assume that America may be under some form of biological attack, and if so, by whom?
Well, I don't think there's any question, Dan, that America is under a biological attack tonight, and I'm not sure, I don't think the evidence is in yet, whether the New York case is even connected to the Florida case. But if it is an attack by Osama bin Laden, particularly let's look at Florida first, it's a very low-tech sort of attack, not the thing I've spent the last 7 years studying that keeps me awake at night. This is not that sort of attack. And it appears to me one of the best method to use a biological attack is with surprise. So I don't think that this is it demonstrates that Osama bin Laden is making this attack, or if he is, he's a very poor strategist, because our public health system is on top alert right now in this nation. And so, as your other experts have said, this is treatable. We have to catch it early like we are in these cases. We're going to see more of these, but this is not a serious threat, and it's not something people should be losing sleep over tonight.
What do the American people need to know? Is there anything they should do?
Yeah, one of the things that we've been talking about lately, animals are great sentinels. For you or I to be infected, Dan, we have to get 10 to 18,000 anthrax spores. That sounds like a lot, but it'll fit on the head of a pin. But a cow only needs 100. A cat is even a better sentinel. So if you have an animal or a pet that has died, you need to report that to your animal control unit. You need to report it to your local veterinarian. Cats are particularly good because it gets in their hair, they clean themselves, and they will be the first ones to show symptoms of anthrax. Early detection is the key.
Colonel, there are all kinds of wild scenarios, rumors floating around. What strikes you as a possible scenario that worries you?
Well, certainly not these, but the one that could be done, particularly if it was a nation state like Iraq was using some of the capability that we think they have, used in an indoor auditorium or something like that. It's very difficult to do outdoors, but used indoors, there could be a problem. And that's like the president said last night, we need to be on alert. If you're in an auditorium, a basketball stadium or something like that, and you see someone spraying something, you know, you have to do some visible things to release this into a crowd. Tell someone, that's very important. That early detection is the key.
Colonel Randy Larson, thanks.